They point us to the greatest book of science and history that's ever been written, and that, of course, is the Bible.
Über uns die Lerche zieht, sie singen auch wie wir ein Lied. Alle Vöglein stimmen fröhlich ein, o Helen und Sonnenschein.
Greetings, YouTube misfits, miscreants, malcontents, and misanthropes. Claire's here, I got coffee. Come on in, we're going to talk about YouTube and YouTubers. I want to start out today with a little North Carolina update. You may recall that a month or so ago I talked about a bill before our state legislature that would make it illegal for scientists working for the state of North Carolina to utilize scientific methodologies to project sea level rise. The problem was, their methodology projected that over the next century, sea level would rise by about 3 feet. Needless to say, that threw our coastal development and realtor communities into a tizzy. And since our state legislature works for the realtors and the development community, they went to work. They passed the bill, and just last week, Governor Beverly Perdue decided not to veto it, and so it's the law of the land.
How high's the water, mama? 3 feet high and rising. How high's the water, papa? She said it's 3 feet high and rising. Well, the hives are gone, I lost my bees. Chickens are sleeping in the willow trees. Cows in water up past her knees. 3 feet high and rising.
Some of you have asked how I find these crazy people I make fun of. Well, I find them by various means. Sometimes people just tell me about them. One of the best sources for information on wingnut crazy people is RWW Blogs, also known as Right Wing Watch. I highly recommend that channel, but you do need a strong stomach.
Of liberalism, it really is a hatred for God.
A country that's being forced to turn away from God because of the liberals gets things like the Colorado massacre in abundance.
And we've tried it the liberals way for 60 years now. What do we got? We have massacres in Aurora. 12 people shot dead while they're watching a movie at midnight.
Because now in our culture, if you say something is wrong, if you want to raise your family and teach your children right and wrong, you're likely to be persecuted in some way by the government.
Her daddy wears a turban around Lexington, and her mama wears a ruby between her head. We got a raghead in Washington. We don't need a raghead in the state house.
The single greatest threat to religious liberty in America today is the homosexual agenda. In the wake of what we've just seen at Penn State, I mean, this ought to be just enough to tell us that alone ought to be enough to say, look, we are not going to put children in same-sex houses.
And folks who cannot reproduce want to recruit your kids.
How in the world is it that African Americans still support the Democratic Party? How can you explain that? And the only reason we could see why the Democrat Party still has support in the African American community is because the Democrat Party promises them more goodies. They're like drug-addled addicts. And the Democrat Party has gotten them addicted to welfare benefits. And
we need to steal back the rainbow. We can't let the gays have it. We're the Rainbow Coalition. We're the Army of God. We're the Covenant People of God. And we are going to take back America in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Then I believe in November, God is going to have mercy on our land, and we're going to have a renaissance of the values that made this country great, namely faith in God.
To the atheist watching this telecast, there are planes leaving every hour on the hour, going every place on planet Earth. Get on one. We don't want you, and we won't miss you.
You know, I'd consider taking John Hagee's advice, but, well, I'm looking forward to dancing and spitting all over his grave after he chokes on one of those large sandwiches he obviously enjoys. Someone has to get into the action. Speaking of wingnuts and homophobia, obviously there's been a big brouhaha concerning Chick-fil-A. And that led to a really interesting conversation among our little group about what local governments can and cannot do to prevent businesses that support unsavory causes from locating within their jurisdictions.
I was already annoyed with Chick-fil-A being closed on Sunday, so learning that they have been giving millions of dollars to groups who actively fight against the rights of others, and even go so far as to set up clinics to cure the people of their supposed sexual dysfunction, was just the nudge that I needed to jump into the already saturated body of WTF. Within the past few days, there have been a few elected officials who have threatened to deny permits, building permits, or business licenses to Chick-fil-A. All states have the right to deny business permits to corporations who want to set up their shop in their respective territory. Some of these denials are for practical reasons, as you might think, and others are for ideological reasons.
Interesting assertion. And now for an opposing point of view.
Boycott them all you want. Argue for people never to shop there all you want. But you don't get to deny them the right to open up a business in the first place just because of their beliefs. What if Alabama banned pro-choice women from opening up a business? Would you sit there, shrug, and say, well, that's fine. It's not an abuse of government power. And you would argue that it's unconstitutional.
Cardinal Virtues is correct, and despite Meridian Frost's assertions, local governments don't have unlimited power to deny things like building permits or business licenses. They cannot do so on the basis of, well, we just don't like them. To do so is an arbitrary and capricious exercise of the local government's police power. If they attempt it, they will most likely be sued, and I can pretty much guarantee they will lose in court. And that is black-letter land use law. Now, the simple fact is, if you don't believe in free speech for anyone except people with whom you agree, you don't believe in free speech. And Josh, with regard to this statement,
all states have the right to deny business permits for ideological reasons.
All I can say is,
Jane, you ignorant slut.
Now, like Meridian Frost, we all occasionally do or say something stupid. But there are people out there who make a living making moronic statements, and I think it's high time we considered some Olympian stupidity. Given you a little slice of both today's nominees. Our first nominee is Brian Fisher of the American Family Association. Take it away, Chuckles.
What once was considered scandalous, once was the infamous crime against nature, that was the legal term for homosexual behavior. You and I know exactly what the solution to this moral dystopia is. It is reaffirming in our culture the time-honored moral standards of the Judeo-Christian tradition. It is altogether right for a rational culture to discriminate against homosexual behavior. We cannot trust the sexual integrity and innocence and purity of young children to those that have same-sex preferences. The risk is far, far too high. We can't have homosexuality in the First Amendment. If homosexuality is embraced and normalized, That's the end of the First Amendment. It's gone.
Isn't Brian a charmer? Our next nominee, Dr. Thomas Kendall of South Carolina, wishes to share a few words on the subjects of geology and evolution.
Many Christians have been intimidated on this subject by the so-called fact of Earth history and science called the evolutionary geological column.
Actually, Sugar Britches, it's just geologic column. You see, evolution has to do with biodiversity. It's a biological concept. Geologic column has to do with rocks in Earth history. Doesn't have to do with biology.
But there are a lot of good, solid scientific and logical reasons not to believe this. The first and most important one is it denies the testimony of the one eyewitness who was really there to tell us about history.
What Dr. Kendall is saying is that the accumulated knowledge of modern geology published over the past couple of centuries contradicts the tales at the beginning of this book, and Dr. Kendall is devoted to this book. Dr. Kendall is suggesting that a small band of ancient Middle Eastern agrarians, so ignorant of the natural world, they thought everything from rainbow to spring showers to earthquakes were the result of whims of their invisible thunder god, actually knew more about Earth history than modern scientists.
Those bones are in the ground not to test our faith, but rather to support our faith. If biblical history is true, creation took place, what would we predict about the fossil record? The fossil record would show no transitional fossils. And indeed, there should be many millions, but there's only a handful that they're even willing to argue about today. And they're so questionable, so equivocal, that many evolutionist experts don't even accept them.
Well, of course, that absurdity has been laughed to shame so many times, I don't need to address it. Suffice it to say that Dr. Kendall imagines transitional forms as phantasmagorical chimeras that never existed and evolution doesn't predict would exist. Everything you need to know about Dr. Kendall, whose degree, by the way, is in medicine, is summed up in this statement.
They point us to the greatest book of science and history that's ever been written, and that, of course, is the Bible.
Two strong candidates today, but Dr. Kendall is just another in a long line of creationist buffoons with his head inserted firmly between his buttocks. Brian Fisher, on the other hand, is an authoritarian hate monger who would have no problem ordering someone to put a bullet right through my brain. Congratulations, Brian. But before we give the award, I want to give a shout out to some of his enablers. Monstrosities like Brian Fisher and the AFA could not prosper without a lot of help. One source of help is Dan Cathy of Chick-fil-A. Brian is further enabled by weasel politicians like Mitt Romney, who has been kissing this guy's ass since the beginning of the campaign. So this song is for the lot of you sons of bitches.
Were you born an asshole? Or did you work at it your whole life? Either way it worked out fine, 'cause you're an asshole tonight.
Okay guys, that's another show. I'll try and be back soon with another science video.
I'm heading for the last roundup.
Gonna saddle old Pain for the last time and ride. So long, old pal, it's time you're here.